silent, and his or her silence will not be held against him or her. The petitioner also has the right to testify and have his or her testimony considered under the same standards as that of other witnesses. I may ask questions of witnesses on both sides as the evidence is presented. This is not a criminal or traffic court proceeding. Strict rules of evidence are not applied during this hearing, but due process shall be observed and govern these hearings. Based upon the testimony and evidence presented, which shall include a review of the photographic or electronic images and the streaming video, I will determine whether or not a violation of Florida law has occurred. I shall uphold or dismiss the violation and issue a final administrative order. If the violation is upheld, the final administrative order
No, but right now I can't pay the fine.
Okay, the maximum, and I appreciate your honesty. That's very nice of you.
Yeah.
And based upon the city's evidence and based upon your testimony here today, I'm going to uphold the violation. So that is the $158 statutory penalty and the $100 administrative cost. However, I can give you up to 90 days to pay.
Yes.
So that's 3 months.
Okay.
That's the maximum I can give.
Right now, I don't have no income. I go to my disability here next month, the end of next month, and if I can get it, I can.
Okay. And I wish you nothing but the best of luck with the disability.
Yes.
All right. Based upon the evidence and the testimony presented here today, I'm going to go ahead and uphold the violation. Mr. Weeks, again, paid the statutory penalty of $158, the administrative cost of $100, and you have 90 days to pay, which is the absolute maximum that I'm permitted to allow.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Appreciate you coming in.
All right.
Thank you for your honesty.
Yeah.
If you have any questions about the administrative order or how to
extend through the intersection because of brake being wet. Now, they allow those cars on the road, there has to be some variables there.
Do you have anything else you would like to tell me? Any other witnesses you'd like to present or any other
I'm the only one there. There are no witnesses except me and that camera.
All right. Well, I appreciate your honesty as well, sir. But based upon the evidence, I'm going to uphold the violation. I'm going to order that you pay the statutory penalty of $158 and the administrative cost of $100 within 90 days. If you have any questions about the administrative order or how to make a payment, the clerks have indicated that they are available on Monday morning downstairs on the first floor, or you can call.
I can't go down and pay right now?
I believe you...
My credit card or debit card?
Yeah.
All right, I believe Madam Clerk is going to assist you with the payment of that. Thank you, sir.
I tried to slow down, but when the light turned red, stopped a little bit past the when I hit my brakes a little bit past the white line. If I would have slammed on brakes, I would have been in the middle of the inch, so I ain't had no choice but to keep going.
Can you run that
number
one more
time?
Yeah,
actually, brakes.
All right, do you have anything further, any witnesses or any evidence that you'd like to present?
I don't have no witness or evidence. I mean, I stopped, like my brake lights were on. I wasn't speeding, so I had to slow down.
But unfortunately, you ran the red light, and based upon the evidence presented here today, I'm going to uphold the violation. Mr. Young, you're going to need to pay the statutory penalty of $158 and administrative cost of $100 within 90 days. Do you need 90 days? I can give you sooner if you want.
90 days?
Okay. If you have any questions about the administrative order or how to make a payment, then you can speak with the clerk. I believe want to know, is there a way, because the gentleman that was before me with the Mustang, is there a way to show the camera, because I saw on his side, my defense is to show on the opposite end, there's an Athenian Gardens right there on the corner, and it would have to be the other way, you know what I mean, if I was driving northbound. I don't know if there's a way, it only shows it that going southbound, if that makes sense.
So right now, we're looking northbound?
Yeah, if it would be to the right, I didn't know if there's a way to do different angles on the camera.
No.
Okay.
Do you have any other questions, Ms. City?
That's my other question.
And in this video, the Athenian Gardens you're referring to, is it on the left-hand side?
It's right on this right-hand side, yeah, there you go.
Okay, so on the left. All right, City, do you have any other evidence or any other witnesses to present?
No, just, again, pedestrian started across there, and I don't see any vehicles that would impede her from being able to stop.
All right, and do you wish to put it out, and like the video and put it out into evidence? Okay, and Ms. Harmon, what would you like to tell me?
Well, I already read the red light, that's obvious. And I'm going to pay the fine, but my question was wanting to show, because I actually am, I have a case another against this guy. We have a business right down 4th Street. It's actually been demolished for Trader Joe's to come in. There's a gentleman that would come into our restaurant, and he drives a yellow Camaro. You can't see it in the video, that's why I wondered if it would delay it and show it. He had been driving downtown, riding my tail the whole way. I have a newborn that's screaming. Back and forth. I know I have to pay it, but I was hoping that it showed his license plate because he's actually been thrown out of our restaurant. He lives back in our neighborhood. He was tailgating me aggressively because he saw that it was me in the car and he was trying to get me to pull over. And I was just, my nickname's Turtle. You know, I drive really slow. So, I mean, I know that I had it, but I told my husband the reason I came today is I was hoping that it showed his car behind me going through it because I want his license plate. And it's really unfortunate because he lives back in our neighborhood. He runs through the stop sign. He almost hit a kid the other day. We've gotten verbal altercations, and we actually had a police officer have him removed from our restaurant right before we closed. So I was just hoping that it showed his license plate.
Have you called the police department?
They've given him a warning not to come back into our location right before it was demolished. But I wanted to get his license plate because he was actually following me. And that's what was unfortunate about it. It's because I don't ever speed. I had the baby in the car, and he's screaming his head off. He's, you know, 2 months old, and I was terrified. So, I know I have to pay it, but I was just hoping that it showed his license plate.
Show me the vehicle one time, please.
I know, I was hoping it showed it so bad. And
to give me the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Yes, I do.
And thank you.
I'm Bill, the infraction officer with the St. Petersburg Police Department. This is a straight-through violation, which occurred on 1-10-14 at 12:02 p.m. at 38th Avenue, 34th Street North. A shot shows the vehicle. The Nissan, black in color, eastbound on 38th Avenue in the second lane. Speed shows 34 miles an hour. Light had been red 14 tenths of a second. Amber light 4.4. State requirements 4.4. B shot is now in the middle of the intersection and the light has been changed to 1.8 seconds. Which shows the tag. 373-13H. Going to David and this question to Mr. Stanley.
If you can, City, go back to that A shot one more time, please. Thank you. Do you have any questions of the city?
Not for the city itself, no, ma'am.
All right. Do you have any other evidence or witnesses you'd like to present?
I need to run the video.
All right. Is there anything else the city would like to present? Witnesses, evidence?
Please don't have any document to evidence.
All right. And do you have any questions of the city after watching the video?
No.
Okay.
Let's take anything else, but on this day here, Your Honor, I wasn't driving the car. I was in bed sick. The reason why I know this was on the 10th and on February 9th is my birthday. Now I know I could be sent an affidavit. I have just for some forms. And it was showing me something with the computer, but I'm computer illiterate. Because the person that lived at my house was going there to pick up my medicine. And I wasn't aware that he went through a red light, to be honest with you.
All right, and where, this actually happened on January 10th, not February 10th.
I mean, I know, that's why I know the dates. Mine's the 9th, and this happened on the 10th. So that's why I know, because of the dates.
Okay, what day is your birthday?
On the 9th.
Of what month?
February. This happened in March.
No, this happened in January.
I know that, that's my birthday, January 9th.
I thought you just said your birthday was February 9th.
February 9th, right.
So, is your birthday January or February 9th?
February.
So your birthday is February 9th?
Right.
Alright, well, they allege that this occurred on January 10th.
I know that.
A month before.
I know that. That's why I know, because it was January. And my brother and sister's date is on January 9th, too. On January 9th.
So your brother and sister's birthday is January 9th, and your birthday is February 9th.
Right.
All right.
So bank on by those dates.
Who was staying at your house?
Edison Formosa, if I pronounce his name properly. He was a boarder at my house, if I pronounce his last name properly.
How long was he a boarder at your house for?
For about 11 months, Your Honor.
Is he still there?
No, ma'am.
When did he leave?
ain't picked it in.
Was he gone before or after Christmas?
Was he there for Christmas?
That's December.
I know, it's December. Was he there for December? He was out here before Christmas, if I remember right.
All right, so if he was out before Christmas...
I don't know, I don't remember.
If he was out before Christmas, then how was he living in your house to take your car in January?
I don't remember.
Okay.
I think he was in Christmas. It's like 4 months ago, so go back 4 months.
All right, 4 months is before when this happened.
Yes. But this year, he was moved out. And when did he move out? I try and get the time factors right.
I know, so am I.
Try and get the time factors right. He's been out of my house. What we see if I do? Give me a second, Your Honor.
That's okay. You don't have to call me, Your Honor. I'm a district officer.
Two and a half months. He's about 2.5 months, 2 months.
Okay, so was he there in January when this happened?
Yes.
All right. And where do you live in relation to this?
About 5 blocks.
Okay.
6 blocks. Supposed to be going to Walgreens. That's right across the street from there.
The Walgreens at 38th Avenue and 34th Street?
Right. Why he's going through that red light is beneath me. Because Walgreens is right there.
All right. And why didn't you fill out the form?
Well, the form didn't come with it. They said to go online. I'm computer illiterate.
All right. Does the city have any evidence or testimony with regards to the availability of the form for Mr. Sackow?
You can go down to the
Is that written on the ticket itself?
On the ticket it says they can go to violationinfo.com, but he's not literate on the computer.
Can I take a look at his ticket that was issued to him? You don't have to pull it up on the screen.
Take your time, Your Honor. No problem. I got no babies on the feet, so. Okay, this is something about going through the computer, getting an affidavit. I figured I'd come down here and get the affidavit.
All right. I'm going to dismiss the violation against you here today.
Yes, ma'am.
But in the
that.
Future, if someone borrows your car and runs
well,
the red
light... Well, this isn't the only time that ever happens.
But if it ever happens again... You need to go to the city of St. Pete, to the clerk downstairs on the first floor, or to the police department, and ask them for the affidavit, okay?
Okay, yes, ma'am.
I'm just explaining it to you now. So I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt today.
Ma'am.
But generally, if it's on there and you have the option to go to sign the affidavit, you need to do the affidavit.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
But today, I'm going to dismiss the violation.
Thank
Good
you,
luck to
that.
You. Don't let boarders, random boarders, drive your car.
It's the first time I ever did it, man.
Well,
trust
I hope
me.
It's the last.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you.
so I know nobody's walking, not knowing, but I just do it so many times that I didn't think I was going to be wrong. I just took that right there.
But one of the issues is with it is visibility. To his left, he can't get a good vision. He has to look in three different directions. He has to look to the left to see that it's safe. Looks in front of him, he sees those cars, but he still has to look coming up there. And if there's been somebody over to the right, and he's looking to the left, going 22 miles an hour, he wouldn't have time to safely
control within, they could have a sign over there that says no turn on red, like most other intersections. This, the only time this is a stop that's got a red is when those things light up. And the only time they light up is when the northbound side proceeds.
All right, the question here today is not the requirement of whether or not you needed to stop at that intersection. It's whether or not when you proceeded to turn right through that intersection, you did so in a careful and prudent manner. Mm-hmm. There has been a case out there in our circuit, Judge Overton, that has stated, you know, generally 12 miles per hour when you make the turn is careful and prudent. Anything under 12 miles per hour when you're making that turn, that's done in a careful and prudent manner. Once you get above that, you've got to look at the other factors regarding the turn at the intersection. So, you know, not to be confused that whether or not you have to actually stop at that light when the black box isn't looked up. I just want you to realize that I'm looking at whether or not your turn was done in a careful and prudent manner based upon the evidence presented here today. In looking at the evidence presented here today, I'm going to dismiss the violation because I don't see any traffic at the point when you're approaching the intersection. I also don't see any pedestrians. It seems free and clear, and it does not appear that your view was obstructed looking from east to west for you to make the turn. So I'm going to dismiss the violation.
Thank you.
You're done. Thank you. Slow down, though, when you make that turn. Next up, Cassandra
Didio.
Didio, okay. They're getting me with these names today. Didio. All right, Ms. Didio, if you can hold on for one moment. Cindy, are you ready to proceed?
Yes, I am. I'm Debbie Frye, infraction officer with the St. Petersburg Police Department. This is a right turn on red violation, which occurred on 1714 at 11:16 a.m. at the location of 38th Avenue North and 66th Street. This is the A shot showing a blue Hyundai eastbound on 38th Avenue North in the right curve lane. Speed shows 15 miles per hour. Light has been red for 13.3 seconds. Amber light 4.4. State requirement is 4.4. This is B shot. Vehicle is now out of sight. The light has been red for 15.2 seconds. This is the tag number, AJGN91. The tag was run through DMV and is registered to the petitioner, Cassandra.
Good deal.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. This is the video. Do you have any questions of the city?
Not at this time.
All right. And city, do you have any other witnesses or evidence to present if I have not already asked you?
No, ma'am.
All right. And you've already put your documents and video to evidence.
Thank you.
All right, ma'am, what would you like to tell me?
Well, I would like to say that I think it clearly that was a prudent turn. I couldn't see it as much on this video as I could at home, but my brake lights come on after I'm in the shot, so I'm not sure exactly how they say the speed I'm traveling, but I'm fairly certain that I was not going 15 when I went through the intersection. You can watch my brake lights come on. I clearly slow down. There's nothing obstructing my view. The other line is turning, there's no pedestrians, there's no reason for me not to make a turn at that point, and I do believe it was a prudent turn.
I am actually going to dismiss this violation as well, based upon the totality of the evidence, the speed being 15 miles per hour, the petitioner appearing to brake as she's approaching the interstate, or is the intersection braking even more, in addition to the traffic that's traveling from northbound to westbound, thus blocking the two pedestrian ways closest to the vehicle.
Thank you.
Thank you, have a great day. All right, next up we have Xavier Gray.
I know that day it was raining. There was four people in the car. There's generally not four people in my car. So between those two things, I definitely weighed it down a little bit. After that, when I was going, I went to put the brakes on, and you can kind of see it going through the entire thing. They weren't sticking. I just kept sliding. So I was braking for probably about 150 feet, and it just didn't happen. And so you can see the brakes on until about the crosswalk. And then once I got to about the crosswalk and realized that there was no way my car was going to stop even in the middle of the section, I just went on through. So I proceeded generally slow as I could with the brakes going, and then it just didn't happen. So I stopped.
Did you fix your car?
I went to the mechanic like the following week to see what the deal was, and they said that the brake booster was going bad. But it was something that, because of the cold weather at that time and the wetness, that it was something that could not work sometimes and other times would be fine.
So they didn't fix anything?
So they didn't fix it. They said that it was, not necessary to be fixed, but advised. And so since then,
Can the city or the